Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Good morning. It's a lovely day. We don't have any mist. And look at how much money I've got. £425,000. And I've done quite a bit, and that £425,000 is after I have bought that Fendt tractor that I did say that I was going to get. So, yeah, that one there, £390,000 for that one. And I've also hired something else, which is a little bit of a treat for you very shortly. We've got big plans this week. First of all, though, the question I asked last week was, do you want me to do any whole crop silage? And everybody pretty much said, yes, they would like me to do some whole crop silage. So I will, although I don't actually have any clue as to which field we're going to do whole crop in yet or which clamp we're going to put it in. Because we've got two up there, we've got one there, and we've got one down there. So I don't really know where we're going to put it, but we will do it. I've also got... what have I got? I've got 100 cows at the moment. I'm going to buy another 100 cows now, so that will put us at 200. We've got 7,000 straw in there. We've got no silage. So I think the 7,000 straw will do for today. We've only got one bale left down here anyway. We've got some more up the top. So we will go and get some more. But the question that I'm going to ask you for this week is, because we're going to be making hay very shortly, we're going to need some feeding technology. So, do you want me to get this Kuhn SPW25, which holds 25,000 litres, quite a big machine, self-propelled, so hence the price tag on it, or we've got this trailer, the Peecon Bigger Mammoth. This one is 64,000 litres. Not quite as much as that one, because it's a trailed and not a self-propelled one, so you've got to tip everything in, including the silage, whereas this one can load itself with silage. So, you've got 25,000 there, and you've got 64,000 there. These are both fantastic. They're both good mods. They look different to the standard game ones, so it's kind of refreshing that you've got something that looks a little bit different. So it's your vote, it's your game. Which one do you want? The Kuhn SPW25 or the Peecon Bigger Mammoth 64? Right, dust that bit done. There we go. So I need to get some silage, so I'm going to use this tractor to do that. Let's start you up. I'm going to drop the cultivator straight in the shed there. I'm not going to bother washing it off, because I'm in a hurry. We've got a lot of things that we need to do. I'm going to rush this trailer, the Marshall trailer here, up to the BGA. The JCB loader is already up there, ready and waiting. That's terrible parking, Frith, but that'll have to do. Let's come over here. Oh, I've got to lower it. Right. Lower it down. Now get out. Get stuck on the post. Come round. There. Now we can unload that one. Right. Let's go get that trailer over there. And then I will rush up to the BGA. And I will also buy the 100 dairy cows. So that will take us up to 200. I don't really know if we're going to be able to get 500 cows before I finish this map. Because I don't really want to just sit and harvest millions of trees. Just so that we can get the 500. Because I'd be doing the entire thing off screen. Because you're not going to want to sit and watch me do all of that. So I am wondering if it would really be sort of an exercise in futility. Perhaps 500 was a little bit ambitious for a Let's Play series, purely because it's just going to be really dull watching it. You know, there's all the extra stuff that I've got to get. So I apologise for that. I am pretty much getting everything else covered that I said I would do. All the questions that I've asked you, I've made notes of them all. And I am slowly getting there. So we'll just rinse this one off. And then I'll nip up and get silage, and then we can get started on the real treat. We got a lot of work to get done this week. We got quite a bit of new machinery to test out as well, which is going to be awesome. I dropped the trailer off down at the silage clamp, and I've then taken the tractor on down to the livestock yard, where it will be able to hitch on to the livestock trailer when we need it. And I've come up here to get our new tractor. Look at this beast, this monster. This thing is huge. What a tractor. Just look at that. I mean, just look at the front. He looks angry. He looks like he's gonna take on anything. This tractor is good. Right, let's get in it and start it up. First of all, let's just have a look inside. What do we got? Do we have, yes, we have an IC. So let's see what the IC does. Whoa, we got everything here. open the cool box. Okay. That slides out the front there. Brilliant. You can open that and lift that bit up. Open the telephone. Oh, yeah, you got a phone. You put the panels up. Let's put the phone on there. We put the cool box in. So when it says open, it just provides it. You can bring down the sun screen there, the parasol type thing. Mirror in there. It's this one. Another sunscreen in the front. Oh, this is... the level of detail on this is phenomenal. And you have the side signal out. What's on the back? Open up the back window. Well, we'll keep that one closed because obviously this is a very modern tractor. This is so... we're not going to need to have windows open. We have full air conditioning. Open colour. Oh, I see. You can change the colour of the seat. Well, we'll leave it like that for now. Open the tank. Ah. Oh, that does something outside. You can even take the mudguards on and off. Open up and close the bonnet. Oh, this is sensational. Here we got... we've got the other signal there. I'll leave the signals out. I think that'll be good. That is the passenger seat there. We'll leave the passenger seat on. And... guessing that's a fire extinguisher from outside. And then obviously you can open the door. So let's turn that off and just come outside of cab a minute and see... right there. So you can zoom in and you can... You can't quite reach them from here. Yeah, you can see them, but you can't quite reach them. So if we go in cab and we open that one, and then we go out of cab again, turn off the IC, there you can see inside. Look at that. Sensational. Right, let me close that one down again. Enable the IC, close you down, and off. Right, so that's enough messing around. Let's start her up. Backloader console on off. What does that do? Oh. I'm not quite sure what that is, to be honest. I'm assuming it's a quick hitch type system. And then... What's 9? Oh, that must be to prepare for the secondary wheels, I guess. When we've got the wheels there... Change drive direction. Oh, it's one of these. I had no idea. I knew this was a good mod, but I had no idea. Oh, wow. Oh, that is sensational. Okay, I am seriously impressed with that. Oh, that is amazing. Right. Now, if I put the backloader console on, does that mean I can pick up those wheels? One way or another. Let's have a look and see if... assemble twin wheels. There we go. If I move away. Right, so they've got to be somewhere nearby. Can I pick up this thing? Because I don't want to be driving around with twin wheels on all the time. Let me just go over here. I'm very aware that I have actually got a lot of stuff that I need to do, and I can't just be playing with this new toy. This is sensational. This tractor is amazing. I can't believe I've never actually tried it before. Let me hop out and see. Oh, you can open closed door right there. Doesn't actually give me anything there. Right, let's disassemble the twin wheels. There, and I will just see if there is a way to pick this up, and then we've got to drive this over to the silage, over to the BGA. Right, assemble the twin wheels, backloader console on off. So how do you open? Brilliant. Yes, open and close the door. All the little details. Right, it doesn't look like you can pick this thing up. Well, not with that anyway. I was hoping that I could. I was hoping that it would like hop onto the back, because obviously you want to use the twin wheels while you're in the field, don't you? Right, you can't close the door. You've got to go in and use the IC to do that. Like that. So I'm not going to assemble the twin wheels because I don't want to be driving down the road with them. I'll find a way to move them. I might just be able to pick them up with a pallet fork, so I'm hoping that I can. It sounds wonderful as well. And the 46 mile an hour top speed is not too shabby. God, look at this thing. And the suspension is brilliant. But I'm getting over to the silage clamp and we'll get that trailer loaded up and then we can drag it back to the farm. I did actually forget to get a front weight for that Fendt, but I don't think it'll need it for a minute, and when we come to get something a bit heavier on it, then we can worry about it then, even if I just hire one quickly so that it turns up down in the field. We certainly don't need to worry about it at the moment, because that thing is not going to need a front weight just to drag this little old trailer around. So I'm going to put the silage that's left in this clamp into the trailer, and then I will get this back down to the yard and I will buy the cows, and then we can get started on the next thing that we're doing today, which is another wonderful piece of machinery that I think you are really going to love. Just coming back along the track now, the suspension on this thing is absolutely brilliant. So the cab sort of bounces around instead of the seat. It could get a little bit sort of off-putting after a while when you're going along the tracks. But look at the control console on the side there, the stick, which the Fendts do have. All Fendts come with just one control stick like that. But look at how the thing is moving. Every time I put my foot down on my accelerator, that thing slides forward a little bit. And that is an attention, that is a level of detail that I would love to see in all mods. And my personal sort of bugbear is poorly made mods that are only half finished, so you know, really bad textures, so they're all high gloss or really flat planes, things that slide all over the place, don't work properly. I've got a bit of an issue with bad mods, because in my hunt for getting good mods for doing all of my series, I see some absolutely awful ones, okay, and it frustrates me, to say the least. I like to have good mods. I like to be able to offer good mods to everybody that watches. And this one here, this tractor, this is absolutely amazing. I can't remember who it was that told me that I should get this one, but yeah, thank you to everyone. I know that it was more than one person that suggested it. Thank you to everybody that suggested that I try this mod. This is amazing. He's a little bit, he's dancing now. He's so pleased with my glowing report that he's dancing in the field for sheer joy. Right, let's get out of here. And then I got something else to show you next, and it's the sort of the big job that we're doing for the week. Just going to park this one right here, and we'll stop that one. What do I want to do? I just wanted to take a quick look at changing the drive direction. Can I do it? Apparently I can't do it at the moment. Why can't I do it now? It might be because I've got the tractor hitched onto something. I guess so. Anyway, we'll just switch this one off now. There we go. And into cab, enable the IC, open the door, climb out and shut the door again. Look at that. What a fantastic machine. If all mods were made to this standard, it would be sensational. And don't get me wrong, the mods that I use in this game, I very rarely use a mod that I'm not happy with. Unless I'm absolutely forced to, I don't use it. And like this next mod, a few people have had some issues, but I think it was purely because of the graphics on it. Previously, me personally, I have tested this one out, and I'm loving it. So our next big job, which is our main sort of task for this week, is to do some mowing. We're going to do some mowing. We're going to gather a load of grass for the cows and for the sheep. And, oh, I actually meant to get some cows, didn't I? Hang on a sec. There you go. 200 cows. So we have 200 cows. and we've got, so we're going to get a load of grass, we're going to do some silage, I don't know how much silage, but we're definitely going to do some silage, and we're also going to do some hay. So I was having a little think, and I think what we will do is map view, yeah, right, 1, 2 and 18, as we'll sort of, we'll do those three there as hay, I think. No, actually, we'll do those as silage. We're going to do those as silage because we can make a silage clamp right here back at the yard. And field number 9 down there, we'll do that as standard grass. 48 is going to be hay. We'll probably do 41 as hay as well. That'll be silage, and those two will be silage. Something like that. But I'm going to mow 1, 2, 18, 9, 8, 43, 41, 48, and 45. I'm going to mow all of those fields. And so I needed something a bit bigger. And look at this thing. This is a Krone Big M, and it's done in black. A special edition black Krone Big M. Now, this thing has a 13.5 meter cutting width. It is awesome. So I've hired this for the day. Obviously, this is not something that we would be buying. This has just been hired for the day, but it has everything that we could possibly want. Now, unfortunately, the same button that you press to open the door on the cab is also the one that you press to unfold everything. So we are going to have to run with the door open, because if you try to close the door, it folds everything up. And I didn't want to bother remapping the keys. Very lazy on my part, I know, but that's just the way it is. Right. There's nothing, there's no sort of particularly special extra options on it, except when it does have a hitch on the back that we could use if we wanted to, but I don't want to. What I'm going to do, though, is I'm going to come over near the edge of the field, because obviously we've been, it's a hire machine, it's been dropped off right here. So we'll come over here, and this one will deposit all the grass in a swath if we want it to, and I'm going to leave it in a swath in some of these fields, and then some of them we won't. The ones that we're going to do for hay, we'll just cut them flat, and then the rest of them we'll leave it in the swath, and then we can pick it up. So that's lowered down, started up. Look at that. How awesome is that? The Krone Big M, 13 meter cutting width. So today we are going to be doing quite a bit of mowing, as you can probably imagine. But the day is actually nearly done. We've gotten all excited looking at our new Fendt tractor and got the silage and stuff. So yeah, I've mostly sort of been fanboying over that new tractor, and I haven't actually done very much. So I will be doing quite a bit of mowing tomorrow as well, so that we can sort of see this thing in action, because this machine, look at this. I've seen video of machines like this working. This one, and then Class, they do one. I can't remember what it's called. It's a there's the Class Octopus that has it's like a hedge trimmer thing, and it's got 5 hedge trimmers on it. It looks impressive. It really does. If you go onto YouTube and you want to see some videos of real machines working away, go and have a look at a channel called Tractor Spotter. They do some absolutely brilliant, really professional quality videos that look brilliant. They use drone footage to do a lot of it, and then they also do close-up footage as well. And they obviously have the full cooperation of the operators of the machinery, because they do in-cab stuff as well. It is brilliant. If you want to see some of this machinery actually working, that is the channel to go and take a look at. But that aside, I have seen video of these great big grass cutting machines, the self-propelled ones, working. You don't see them, obviously. It's a very specialist sort of machine, and you're not going to have very many people that could justify the cost of something like this, unless you're like a huge great big contracting company that does a whole load of it all at once. But yeah, they are brilliant. They're amazing. Absolutely amazing. Let me just come down here and then pick the mowers up, turn around, and I'm just going to do some straight lines now up and down the field just to finish this one off. And look, this huge 13-meter cutting width means that we've already finished this field. I mean, I know this is only a little tiny field, but this one is just about done. So I'm going to fill the cows up completely with grass, and then I'll do the same for the sheep. Now, we've only got 150 sheep at the moment, and I did say I was going to have half as many sheep again as I have cows. So we've got 200 cows. I don't know that we're really going to be able to afford many more cows after this, so I'll get 300 sheep. I'll get another 150 after this episode is finished, and then we can top everything up completely with grass, and then once all the grass and hay and everything is done, I'll go back over and we'll be able to sort of top everything up with silage. Not silage, with straw, because we got that field that we bought the other day, and it's got all the rows of straw down. That's the only straw that we got available on the map. I got a few bales up the other end, but we do actually have a little bit of a shortage on this map now, so we're going to have to do some combining soon. That's going to be our next big job. So there's that field done already, and I am just about out of time. So what I'll do is I'll switch this one off. There we go. And I'm going to have to fold it up to get through that gateway over there. While I am folding up and moving, the question for this week is, do you want me to get... Hang on. Just pause a second. There we go. Because I'm making hay, obviously we're going to be needing some feeding technology. This Kuhn SPW25 is 25,000 litres. And it's a self-propelled machine that will load itself with the silage. Or we can have the Peecon 64, which is 64,000 litres. So it's considerably bigger, but obviously we've then got to spoon the silage into it along with straw and hay. So which one do you want me to use once we start going on to mixed feed with our hay and straw and everything? Do you want the Peecon 64 or the Kuhn 25? It's your vote. It's your game. Head down below. Let me know which one you want. And I will do my best to make sure that I get it. Even if I just hire it, I do love the hire mod. It does mean that we can get these things that we wouldn't normally be able to get. So I will, let's just unfold this one. I will make a start on this field, and then I can finish this field off before the next episode. I love this machine. This is absolutely brilliant. It's a bit overcast today, but I believe the forecast for today, let's have a look at the forecast. I believe it is just cloudy. Yeah, cloudy today, sunny tomorrow. Bit of a shame, because I would like to be able to see this thing a little bit clearer. Never mind. So let's start this one up, and we'll go in cab. See, that's the problem. The only thing I don't like about this one is that you can't see very well in cab, so you can't actually see very much at all when you're in cab. It's not the sort of machine to really do it like this. There we go. Alright, I won't do it in cab. It's just not going to work from in cab, this one. We'll do it like this. We can take a look at it. But anyway, that's all I got time for today. I will join you again tomorrow with more mowing. I got quite a lot of mowing to do, and we'll do some wide spreading as well as gathering it all up into the row like this. And then we've got all sorts of other grass-related activities. I've got a couple more things planned that I think is going to be pretty cool. I don't know if I'm actually going to be able to squeeze it all in this week. We might have to take it on to next week as well. Let me just drive that one around that one. So if you've enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give me a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. One more thing, just before I go. I have, due to quite a few requests, the map that I was playing, the Bjornholm map that I was playing on... nearly hit that gate. For the time-lapse. My time-lapse series? Now that I have finished playing on Bjornholm, the time-lapse map is uploaded on FSUK. It's just as a save game file, so you've got to put it into your save games folder. It's taken from the end of the series, so there's no machinery on it at all, and all placeables have been removed, which means that you don't actually need to install any mods to be able to get it to run. But you've got all of those fields that are all ploughed up and all joined together, massive great big fields, and it's all ready to bale. So if you'd like to have a look at that, it's got 500,000 euros left on it at the moment, because I took some out to pay for the fines to sort of fit in with it. If you want to add a bit more and buy a load of machinery, get the money cheat. But yeah, it's there available if you want to have a go. So that's on FSUK, just in the mod section. It's in save games somewhere. I can't even remember exactly where it is now. I will get back to you, but I'll stop talking now. Until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye and see you later.